Hi everyone and welcome back to the channel. So today I'm making rings and I'm prepping for my first ever craft fair, which believe it or not is in 3 weeks time. Honestly, I must be crazy. Anyway, let's get on to these rings. So I'm using UV resin. This is Let's Resin UV resin. It is my favourite UV resin, but I do run out of it just after making these rings, and I end up using some cheaper resin, which I don't particularly like, but it's all I had in at the moment. So I'm just filling up these molds, these ring molds, earring molds, whatever you want to make out of them, with UV resin, and then I cure them on both sides for 3 minutes. And then I'm going to take them out, and my plan is to, I've got these temporary tattoos, and I'm going to cut them out into a size where they'll fit on the back of the cabochon, and then I'm going to actually put some nail polish over the back of that so that you'll be able to see the tattoo through the nail polish. So I'm just making sure that I've took the plastic off the front of the tattoo, which is normally a fault of mine, and then I place it on there, and I'm just using a baby wipe just to dampen the tattoo. What you do with the temporary tattoos is you dampen the back of them, and then they're supposed to stick on your arm, I suppose, but they'll stick onto the back of the resin. So I get that nice and wet. Eventually I do take off my gloves, because the gloves that I bought the wrong size, or I don't know, I bought medium. Normally they do fit, but these ones were really large, so I was struggling with them a bit. So as you can see, the tattoo sticks to the back of the resin, and I do this on several of these cabochons, and then I just go over the back with some nail polish. This is the cat's eye nail polish, so I do try and get the cat's eye design through. I can't really see it myself, but in certain lights you can, but it was worth the try. So yeah, we tried to do the cat's eye, but you know. Anyway, I decided to go over the back of these with some UV resin just to make sure that the nail polish didn't come off. Now you'll notice I made a mistake here. What am I doing wrong? Can you guess? I do apologise if you can hear next door's dog barking in the garden. I didn't wear any PPE, and I do realise in a moment, and I put a glove on. Naughty. Should always use PPE, guys, when you're using resin. Some people can be allergic to it, so yeah, always use PPE. I do have a mask on, so that's a good thing. But yeah, make sure you are using your PPE. So anyway, yeah, I've got a craft fair coming up. Went out with a friend, my best friend actually, Nicola, a few weeks ago, and well, I'm saying a few weeks ago, it was a couple of weeks ago, and she was discussing whether she was going to do a craft fair. So I said to her, oh yeah, I'll join in with you, that's fine. The date she mentioned was September, so I thought, brilliant, I've got plenty of time to get stuff sorted. But no, she rang me up the day after and she said, oh, I found a craft fair and it's on the 23rd of March. So luckily I do have these things that are already made, the stuff that I've made in past videos, so I can get these out. Yeah, so I can get these and I can make bag charms or keyrings out of them. That bee and the sea with the flowers in were actually the first resin pieces I made. Oh, it's a blast from the past. I mean, it was only last year. I've only been doing this for about 12 months. So yes, for these rings, I glued them down to these little rings that I bought. They've just a flat end, and they're like a size of adjustable ring, that's what it's called. So it has the little thing at the back that you can adjust, and I must admit I do think they look really pretty. So once I've got it sorted, got it where I wanted it, I then let them dry. So for the next set of rings, I decided to add some dried flowers, so I just again filled up the molds with this is the cheaper of the UV resin that I got, and then I placed in the dried flowers, and I actually put in some gold leaf as well, which I think helped make them look really pretty. So I'm just making sure that the flowers are completely covered with the UV resin, just dividing them out, making them pleasing to the eye, because that's what you want, isn't it, with a ring. And they're very simple to do. It's a simple and easy project for anybody who's new to UV resin. You'll see me adding now this little bits of gold leaf. It's more like a coppery than a gold, but I do like that colour, that's why I bought it. They're just like metallic flakes. I think I paid £1 for the pot from the range in the UK. So I'm just adding that, and then I'll fill them up again with UV resin, and then I will cure them on both sides for 3 minutes. Yeah, so this craft fair that I'm going to, it's over near Lytham St Anne's, near Blackpool in the UK, and I'm actually looking forward to it. I'm a bit scared because it is the first one, so my next few videos may be of me prepping for this and making things for the craft fair, and I do hope you'll watch and you'll enjoy them and you'll subscribe to join me on this journey. So after I made those rings, I decided to use these. They're like a little the four putting stickers for cards, but they're like a foam sticker, so I decided to make these larger love heart rings. But once I didn't attach them to the actual ring, I just thought they were a little bit too big and not the right shape for it, so I didn't actually do those. I've left them to one side and I may turn those into earrings, but I did put the love hearts in the smaller squares that you can see off to the left hand side of the screen there. They look really pretty, and I did also do some more floral ones. So the flower that I used in these, I don't know what it's called, but it's really cute. It's like these little white, like the little white balls. I don't know what they are. They're very autumnal, really, and we are going into spring, but I didn't have any spring flowers left, so that's why I'm using the autumnal ones. But I do think the rings turn out really nice. So once these were all cured and complete, I just followed the same steps as I'd done previously. I glued the actual ring forms to them, and then they were all done. And I do think they look really nice. I'm planning on selling these for about £2 a ring. I don't know whether that's right or not. Let me know in the comments what you think. Also, please do subscribe. It does mean a lot. And do like. Liking and commenting on the channel does help a great deal. It pushes out so that other people can see it. So what do you think, guys? I think these are really pretty. And I am hoping that they will sell well at the craft fair. And please do subscribe to join me on what will be an adventure. Thanks for watching, guys. Bye.